Hey everybody, Mark Leonard Earth. This is Bobcat live from the Art Mines. My dumbass filmed the making of this city rat painting here upside down. My old laptop cannot handle video editing more than just trimming and putting some stuff together. So I'll have to try that again. If any of you want to throw me $600 to buy a new laptop, I'd be real grateful. Anyway, here it is. Finished the mouse head or the rat head out. Paper's got some nice texture on it. It's dry, mostly. This rust glaze that I used for a lot is still wet 3 days later. Amazing. So what I'm gonna do though is frame it, put it in this $3.99 thrift store frame that I have absolutely no love for. Just gonna do a little sanding to take some of this gloss off, smooth out some of the rough bits, and then cover it in this Valspar primer and spray paint satin finish. Want it to be nice and subdued, not take away from the city rat there. Let's get this is glass in the front. I'm gonna take this out. I don't need it. In fact, if you're mounting a painting in a frame for the acrylics, oils, things with a little bit of texture to them, you generally don't want glass. Some people like it, some people don't. I personally don't. I think it takes away from the texture itself of the paint. It doesn't even matter what you're looking at, just the texture of the paint, the material it's on, it'll hide behind glass. Let the world see it. So for the back, just gotta pop this out. Great thing about thrift store frames is, you know, they're cheap. You don't have to worry about keeping them. Don't have to spend a lot of money on them. And if you break them, well, no hard feelings. It's only $3. That doesn't look so bad. It's got some nicks here and there, and I'm just gonna smooth that out a little bit. I'm gonna leave these tabs in right where they are. Now, why am I painting brown frame brown? You might ask. Well, it's a little glossy, and I don't want that to overpower the rat. I want this to be nice and subtle, kind of dull. Big thing about framing, you don't want your frame to distract from the art that it's hanging. It wants people to see the art, not the frame. Well, they can see the frame, but not take it away from it. Really good framing, framing done professionally, adds to it, adds a lot of value to it. I heard, I don't know how accurate it is, but I heard sort of a joke where it's like, you get something framed, add a zero to the cost. I don't know if it's that much, but you definitely want to add the cost of the framing, the time it takes to get it framed, all of that to your price of the art. Art is still a business. You don't want to lose money. That's not so bad. You don't want to lose money on it, on your investment time, time and material. That's tolerable. So, make things a little easier for me. Leaving these tabs in is going to come in handy later. Even if they've been bent down, it's easy fix. So, beats as always by Mellow Beat Seeker, YouTube. Give them a listen. Got the door open, maybe a little windy. It's a windy day, but using a well-ventilated area. That's why. Give this a good shake. Here we go. I'm doing the back first because no one will see it. And you're like, well, why am I doing that? I want to make as much of a seal as possible on this. I want to try and prevent moisture from getting in behind this. Some will, that's just the nature of wood. But trying to prevent that as much as possible. Doing the back first, when this is flipped over, any fingerprints, any stupid things I do, any imperfections,
it wasn't meant to be a joke,
will wrap around with the new paint. keep it up off the deck. And you can see, oh no, it rolled over. It dripped down. Well, that's all covered up. So the way I'm doing this, inside, outside, inside again. You want to have as few seams as possible in sort of the cone here. So, quick coat on the inside. Give this a good shake. Nice serious coat from the outside. Oh yeah, this is gorgeous. Look, and one more coat from the inside. Well ventilated area indeed. There we go. Nice thing about spray paint, you lay it on just a little thick. It'll fill in some spots. Now, it's not perfect. This is a thrift store frame. I'm not gonna add a whole lot of value to this just with the frame, but being framed will add some, make it a nice finished piece. All right, back again. Gave this 2 days to dry. Now it's got that nice satin semi-gloss finish. Not leaving any fingerprints or anything on it. Next thing to do, insert Utley Painting. Hold all these tabs up. Just wedge this bad boy right down in there. Hey, look at that. Isn't that pretty? One nice thing about these canvas panels is you can take out the backer on these frames and it fits real nice. It's lovely. So, next stage, hanging hardware. And what I've done is I've marked two little points. All you really need is about a quarter to a third of the way down, whatever that direction you're gonna hang in. And don't need a ruler or anything, just mark a piece of tape. That's good. And that's good. You want it to hang even. Now, depending on your gallery or where you're going to put this, you may have different hanging requirements. So check your submissions to make sure that your hardware is appropriate. Some places want hanging D-rings or, you know, hooks right in the middle here, whatever. That's, check with them. I just use some very simple little screws. Because I'm cheap. Do the job. Just want to give these just enough pressure so that the threads of the screw bite into the wood. You don't want to like force it down because these frames will split. All of your trouble will be for nothing. Betrayed. Betrayed. While you fill up space. It's called vamping. Here we go. There you go. Nice and solid. Didn't scratch this, so no need for touch-ups. And then you can use braided hanging wire. Some people use string. I don't like anything that'll stretch. You don't want this to sag over time. So I'm using OOK or OOK 18 gauge aluminum wire. Just cut a little snip here. Since this weighs next to nothing, you really don't need to like have Fort Knox hanging on the back. Oh no, too short. Cut. Longer snip. I'm cheap, so I hate to waste it. I'll use that later. Give yourself plenty. Hangs just from the center, right there. Ta-da! Now you're ready to submit this to your grandmother, your favorite gallery, or tattoo shop. Don't limit yourself to where you send your art. Thank you for joining me. See you next time.